Okay, illustration 3 from your module. Miss Pearl, an Indian citizen, okay, left India. So she's an Indian citizen, left India for the first time. That means up to this date she was in India on 1st April 2018 for joining job in Tokyo. Alright, she came to India on 11th October 2018 for only 190 days. Determine her residential status for previous year 18-19. Am I clear?
Yes.
Whenever this type of question comes, you should start writing determination of residential status under section 6 subsection 1. Chalo, chalo karo. Abhi likhna hai tum logon ko fir se ek bar. O table. Presentation padha raha hu. Determination of residential status under section 6 subsection 1. Determination of residential status under section 6 subsection 1 likha. What is the format that we are following? You have to create what? Hello, you have to create that table. This table. Alright, you have to write conditions, number of days stayed in India and remark. Condition, number of days stayed in India and remark. Fast, huh? लिखने में अपने को टाइम वेस्ट नहीं करना है. फर्स्ट कंडीशंस, नंबर ऑफ डे स्टेड इन इंडिया एंड लास्ट कॉलम रिमार्क. जब लिख रहे हो तो ट्राई टू बाय हार्ट आल्सो. ठीक है, बोलो पहले क्या लिखते हैं. बेसिक कंडीशन है, एडिशन कंडीशन. बेसिक कंडीशन रोमन वन, बेसिक कंडीशन अंडरलाइन. रोमन वन बेसिक कंडीशन अंडरलाइन. व्हाट वाज द कंडीशन नंबर वन? Stay of 182 days or more in India during PY, during previous year. So write down the first condition. Stay of 182 days or more in India during previous year. Likha? Okay. So let's check ki uske kitne number of days hote hain. So she left India on 1st April only. Okay. So April mein kitne din ruki thi? Miss Pearl, एक दिन. What I told you in the absence of information, date of arrival and date of departure, both shall be included. So April का एक दिन, first day. Alright. Then she came back to India on 11th October. How many days are there in October? 31. And she arrived on 11th October. 11th October to 31st. If you count, I hope it is 22 days. No, 20? 22 days. 11 to 20, 10 days. Then 21st to 30, 20 days. You understand? Or 31st wala. So 21 days. Kyunki 11th October ko hai na, 11th October onwards. Out of 31st, 10 days nahi thi. 10 days nahi thi na, 11th ko aage. So remove that also you can do. Out of 31, you can remove. 10 days, तो 21 days इंडिया में थी, तो अप्रैल का एक दिन, अक्टूबर के 21 days, अक्टूबर के बाद कौन से दिन, कौन सा मंथ आता है?
नवंबर.
नवंबर में कितने दिन?
30.
कैलसी पे काउंट करो ये सब. यहाँ पे मैं ब्रैकेट में लिख रहा हूँ, अप्रैल का वो एक दिन, फिर मई का, नहीं मई वगैरह नहीं है, डायरेक्टली कब आई है? अक्टूबर में कितने दिन? 21. फिर नवंबर 30, फिर दिसंबर 31, जैन 31, फेब 28 एंड मार्च 31, टोटल 173. बताओ सेटिस्फाइड और नॉट सेटिस्फाइड? नॉट सेटिस्फाइड. ऐसे काउंट करते हैं. अगर आपने क्वेश्चन में देखा तो दे विल ट्राइंग टू फूल यू बाय सेइंग शी केम टू इंडिया फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज? 190. If you are dumb, then you will write 190 days there in condition and you will say, okay, she is resident. Hello? You should never trust number of days given by them. She will stay in India for 190 days, but we have to cut off our counting on 31st March itself because we are counting for previous year 18-19 and previous year 18-19 will end immediately on, hello, 31st March. Uske baad wo April mein rukegi, that will not change my residential status of 18-19. You are getting my point?
Yes.
This is institute, ye karte hai log, alright? This is what they do, they are best in that. Likho aise. Done?
Yes.
Okay. So first condition is she became non-resident. Now second condition, what will you write? Second condition part is stay of?
6 days.
Galat. Okay. Yahan pe kitna likhna padega? Stay of 182 days only. Kyun? Because she is an Indian citizen, leaves India for an employment outside India. She is covered by exceptional category. She is a genuine assessee. She is not traveling outside India to evade taxes. Kitna bataya? Alright. And this is a benefit that we are giving to this type of genuine assessee, which is you might be one of this assessee in future. Hello?
Yes.
For leaving India for an employment. So government has replaced 60 days with 182 days. So yahan pe bhi aapko yahi likhna hai. Stay off 182 days or more in India during previous year. Likho. Stay of 182 days or more in India during previous year. Likho, likho, likho. Kitne din likhenge yahan pe? 173. Satisfied or not satisfied? Not satisfied. Ye condition likhkar aapko chhodna hai, lekin count nahi karoge tabhi bhi chalega. Humne declare kar diya usko. What? Hello, she is non-resident. Theek hai. Count karna hota to you would have counted 365, 365, 366 and 365. Last 4 years you need to count like this, which will be more than 1400 days. So you can write here satisfied, but that doesn't make any sense because first condition is not satisfied. So there is no point in satisfying second part of the condition. So instead of wasting time, we can leave it. Okay, in exam mein hum log aise dash karke chhod sakte hain. Done? Table go close karo. Write down. Conclusion. Conclusion. Underline it. Miss Pal is a non-resident assessee. Miss Pal is a non-resident assessee for assessment year 1920, for assessment year 1920, that is PY 1819, that is PY 1819. Okay, theek hai? So there are few more questions or individual that you may try and you may understand. Okay, let me teach few other provisions and then I will give you enough time for writing it. So we are technically done with the theoretical part of individuals. There are few more illustrations given by your institute, like 6 to 7 more illustrations you have for practice. Okay, that we will discuss after, but allow me to teach, finish my section first. Section 6 subsection 2, this is for HUF, residential status of HUF. Very easy. Okay, we will finish it in 2 minutes. Residential status of HUF depends on management and control. It depends on
management
and control. Alright. If management and control is wholly or partly India mein hai. Alright. Wholly or partly. Then that particular HUF will become resident. Okay. Then when will it become non-resident, sir? If management is wholly outside India, some students write wholly and partly here also. See, 100% decisions in India, resident.
Yes.
100% decisions outside India, non-resident. 30% dissidents in India, 70% outside India. Now?
Resident.
1% in India, 99% outside India. Then?
Resident.
Because management and control wholly or partly in India, then it is resident. 100% wholly outside India, then only non-resident. And HUA being it is the entity, it cannot travel. You cannot determine number of days stayed. Alright. Company cannot travel. Have you ever seen? Illimitedly traveling next to in bus and train or flight? No. So entities like partnership firm, LLP, company, they cannot travel. Therefore, the condition number, this residential status conditions are not linked with number of days stayed. That can happen only in case of individual. Hello? Okay. And therefore, residential status of HUA depend upon what? Management and control. Tumhare decisions kahan pe le jate? From where your business is getting control. If it is control from India, then it is resident. If it is control from outside India, non-resident. Partly India, partly outside India, resident. Okay? Huh. Then sir, for OR, NOR, this hashtag, please understand. For once it becomes resident, then we have to check whether it is ordinary resident or? That depends on karta. Okay? One more word you people will add here, karta or manager. You understand who is the main person of the company? Firm HUF in this case, Karta. Karta, you everybody knows, right?
Yes.
But if Karta is of 94-year-old, he's there, he's not dead, he's still there. But do you think a 94-year-old senior most member of the family, Dadaji, is running business now? No, his children are running business actually, okay? So manager is different and legally Karta is different. So they said Karta means they wanted to write Karta, but they don't mean Karta as actual Karta. Karta means a manager of a business who is controlling business. So they have written, your model have written Karta or manager. Okay? So this is how it goes for HUF. Very easy. Section 6 subsection 3. Please understand. This is for company and this is again important. Okay? This is very, very important because Google is a company. Facebook is a company. Hello?
Yes.
Apple is a company and they are not normal company, they are global companies. Okay? And when you drop provision for companies like this, you cannot say wholly or partly in India then resident. Because sometimes YouTube is also, you are running Indian ads also. Alright?
Yes.
They might be having one or two either operations also here in India. You cannot say, okay, Google, you are resident now and you need to pay tax on whole global income here. That should not happen. Okay, and therefore in my law earlier the same wording was there, management and control wholly or partly in India, wholly outside India. This language was there. This language was not justifiable language. Many foreign companies oppose it. How can one decision I took in India, 99 decisions I took in USA, and you are calling partly management was done in India, you are a resident company. So it was very complicated for them, for outsiders, okay, not for India. Now Modi uncle is going abroad, every nation, and they are requesting, okay, please come to India, make in India, digital India. And then companies say, okay, if you make in India, if you open one branch in India, then our global income will be taxable in India because your loss is wholly or partly in India. So to remove this particular, you know, difficulties for foreign nations, foreign companies, they introduce concept of POEM in income tax. Okay, now there is a POEM concept. Now we say, so what is POEM? POEM means place of effective management. Place of? In company management or in companies, who takes decisions, beta? Who takes decisions? Board of directors. Board of directors take decision by passing board resolution, not special. Board resolution. Special resolution or that ordinary resolution happens in AGM. AGM happens once in a year. Alright. Every day-to-day decisions, who take? Directors. Now board of directors means not one person. You understand there are multiple people. So they will come together, they will sit and they will pass a resolution. Usually what happens, you know, sometime if your company is a multinational company, alright, then you will not conduct board meeting in corporate office or any branch office of the company because then other people have to travel to that country, which will be different location. And in India also your company might have, you know, in Delhi also you are having office, in Gujarat also you are having office, in Mumbai also you are having office. So this is possibility. Apart from that, you are having office in Canada and then Australia and then Dubai. Possible, yes or no? And when this board meeting is going to happen, we need to bring all people together. Okay, so usually this big size company, they book hotel which is nearby international airports. okay, and the airport also they check, airport which has best connectivity to all possible nations or major nations through which these people are going to connect it, okay. So Mumbai is the one of the best example. Mumbai has connection to all major cities in the world, okay. So meeting will, they will not conduct meeting in Pune, Nashik, Goa. You understand why? Because their air connectivity is not available. So they, what they will do, they will just conduct meeting here somewhere in nearby airport, either Delhi or Mumbai or Chennai, all right, in some 5-star hotel, and they will decide and they will prepare the resolution. So finding location of decision in a practical life is not that difficult because they are having records. Whatever major decision they have taken are recorded in resolutions, and on resolution you need to write address and date and time. Hello. And though the resolution you will check, if maximum resolutions are passed in India, hello, then we say poem is located in India. What do we say? You understand? If maximum resolutions were passed outside India, then poem is located outside India. Now wholly and partly words are deleted. Now we actually take effective management. Where is effective management is happening? Where major decisions has been taken. You understand? It's not about quantity of resolution. It's about, you know, weightage. More weightage of decision making. More important decisions were taken in India than poem is in India. And that is case to case basis. Therefore, there cannot be question on poem ordinarily at intermediate level. In CA final, there is a possibility now because we are having 100 mark separate paper now for international taxation. We are having 100 mark direct taxation. And then there is another additional paper, 100 mark international taxation. In CA final, we are having 300 marks taxation. 100 mark direct tax, 100 mark indirect tax, and 100 mark additional international taxation, optional subject. If you want, then you can select. Okay. Now, when you reach at CMA final, you are also having 20-25 marks international taxation syllabus. There, they may ask something related to poem. But if they wanted to ask you actual question on poem, it has to be 3-4 page question, which is not possible here. So here question, if they ask, they will simply say poem was in India or poem outside India. Now please say, please see the here, okay. If it is Indian company, okay, it will be so nonsense question if you ask me, sir, what is the residential status of Indian company? Beta, your question is also is having answer. Question itself is having answer. You are asking me what is the residential status of Indian company. What did you say? Indian company. Indian company resident. What is Indian company? Company is incorporated in India. Can company travel here and there? No, their corporate office in India. They were incorporated in India. That means that is the Indian resident company. Then what is the foreign company? Company incorporated outside India. What if I tell you that in Mauritius we are having 2% tax rate and in India we are having 40% tax rate? Where will you like to open company?
Mauritius.
But Mauritius doesn't have scope of development. India has scope of development. So you wanted to do business in India, but you wanted to save taxes. So what will you do? You will incorporate business in Mauritius and you will manage through India or manage in India. Yes or no?
Yes.
Hello, you are getting my point?
Yes.
So what is happening, you know, there are a lot of Videshi companies in India. Please understand the language. There are a lot of Videshi companies in India which are having Swadeshi management. Videshi company, Swadeshi management, that means legally tree is outside India, but management is in India. So they are saying, okay, on paper you are showing tree outside India, but in reality tree is in
India.
So we say foreign company, Videshi company, Swadeshi management is a resident. You are trying to show us as a non-resident, but we will declare it as resident. And if that foreign company become resident, then you know what is going to happen with that company. It's not only Indian income, but global income is going to become taxable in India. This is the impact of poem. You understand poem? How important it is for foreign company. Sir, what about Indian company? Indian company having poem in India, resident. Indian company having poem outside India, resident. They have not written poem below Indian company in law. I am writing it because in exam, to confuse you, they may say, this is Indian company, R Limited, having poem in Canada. So you will feel, oh, poem is Canada, so non-resident. Indian company always resident. What is the law? Indian company?
Always.
Whether poem is in India or poem is outside India. Poem concept is not for Indian company. Indian is resident. Poem is important for which company?
Foreign
company. If foreign company having poem in India, Resident. That means when your foreign company will be considered as a non-resident? They should not have POEM in India. The POEM should be located outside India. Very simple. Yes or no? Alright. So there are four possible combinations. Swadeshi company, Swadeshi management. Bolo, resident, non-resident?
Resident.
Swadeshi company, Videshi POEM. Videshi company, Swadeshi management. Resident. That means Videshi company, Videshi management, non-resident. So only one scope is left now for foreign companies, that they should not keep their POEM in India. Are we clear? Sir, what about resident OR, NOR? Not applicable. In companies, we don't have OR and NOR. That I showed you in your CMA chart. Okay, OR, NOR? Either R or NR. Okay. Sir, what about firm, AOP, BOI and others? Simple like HUF. Management and control wholly or partly in India, resident. Wholly outside India, non-resident. Are we clear about this?
Yes.
Okay. So we will make notes about it and then we will solve some questions. Okay.